He exercises all his brains, that is, assuming that he's got any. Though never nurtured in the lamp of luxury, yet I admonish you, I am an intellectual chap, and think of things that would astonish you. I often think it's comical, a picture always does contrive, that every boy and every gal that's born into the world alive is either a little liberal or else a little
Thank you. tonight is the second reading of this bill to throw the premature to competitive examination.
Oh, and to carry it too.
Carry it? Of course he will. He's a parliamentary patriot. He carries everything.
Yes, that's our fault.
The deuce it is.
Yes, we influence the members and compel them to vote just as he wishes them to. Short instead of eight.
But think what it all means. I don't so much mind for myself, but with a house of peers, with no grandfathers worth mentioning, why the country must go to the dogs!
I suppose it must.
I don't want to say a word against brains. I have a great respect for brains. I often wish I had some myself. But with a house of peers composed exclusively of people of intellect, what's to become of the House of Commons?
I hadn't considered that.
This comes of women interfering in politics. If there is one institution in Great Britain which is susceptible of no improvement whatsoever, it is the House of Peers.
Green. Phyllis, B Company, 1st Grenadier Guards.
You are a fine fellow.
I don't mind.
I can quite understand it. This is a man whose physical attributes are simply... I wrestle with it.
At least I am.
So am I.
No, no.
I am indeed very great.
Friendship's name, and I may
position when you're the only one.
Oh yes, most enviable. At the same time, seeing you thus, we naturally say to ourselves, this is very sad. His lordship is constitutionally blind as a bird. He throws up on the bench like a thing of song and gladness. His civic judgments in F sharp minor, given andante in 6/8 time, among the most remarkable effects ever produced in the court of Chancery. He is, perhaps, the only living instance of a judge whose decrees have received the honour of a double encore. How can we bring ourselves to do that, which was the bright report of Chancery, of one of its most attractive features?
I feel the force of your remarks, but I am here in two capacities, and they clash, my lords, they clash. I deeply grieve to say that in declining to entertain my last application to myself, I presume to address myself in terms that render it impossible ever for me to address myself again. It was a most painful scene, my lords, most painful.
Oh, this is what it is to have two capacities. Let us be thankful we are persons with no capacity whatsoever.
Come, remember, you are a very just and kindly old gentleman, and you need have no hesitation in approaching yourself respectfully and with a proper show of deference.
Do you really think so?
I do.
Well, I will now give myself to another effort, and if that fails, I resign myself to my fate.
If you go in, you're sure to win. Your husband be a charming lady. Be your lord, the angel soul. Fate has never one fair name. Never, never, never.
Down to the waistcoat.
Dear me. Oh, there's nothing to show for it.
Oh, don't do that.
Why didn't you tell me this before?
I feared you would take a dislike to me. But as it's all off, you may as well know the truth. I'm only half a mortal.
But I'd rather have half a mortal I do love than half a dozen I don't.
Oh, I think not. Go to your half dozen.
It's only two and I hate them. Please forgive me.
Oh, I can't. Besides, all sorts of problems would arise.
Thank you.
well armed. I don't think much of the British soldier who wouldn't inconvenience himself to save a fairy in distress.
You are wonderful. You are a fairy from this instant.
Thank you. we're very, very thankful to Katie Holt and Serena for stepping into a role as Fleta and Leila. That gets locked at 10 o'clock on the dot, please. Thank you.